March 7, 1999. We will continue about Satipatthãna, the four foundations of mindfulness. This mindfulness is very important for meditator because this mindfulness is to prevent the mind from wandering to other sense objects and to keep the mind fixed attentively and firmly on a single object of meditation. Therefore, this is the four foundations of mindfulness are indispensable for the development of tranquility meditation and insight vipassana meditation. Their reality here, as all of you know, just sati jitasika, right? Mindfulness, mental factors. Even its reality is the only one. The Buddha explained this the mindfulness as four, right? Satipatthana four, because there are different objects. As all of you know, kaya, nupasana, satipatthana, its object is the body. And vedana, nupasana, satipatthana, object is feelings. Ajitta nupasana satipatthana, the object is mind, consciousness, thoughts. And dhamma nupasana satipatthana, object is dhamma object or mental object. Our last 2 weeks, we already talking about the first one, kaya nupasana satipatthana. What is mean kaya? What we have to contemplate on? So when we contemplate on just our body, especially on the 32 impure parts of our body, that's hair, right? Hair of the body, nails, teeth, skin, flesh, or balls, pus, sweat, blood, saliva, and urine, or pieces, something like that, 32 parts of the kaya, we'll study later. We have 32. We contemplate on one by one. And then, when you see, you will see the body is disgusting, right? Disgusting, you see that. Just the seeing, the object is different, the seeing also is different. You see that disgusting, right? For that's what the Buddha taught us to contemplate on this, our body, to see the disgusting of our body. When you see the disgusting of our body, and then you will eradicate the wrong view that this body is very beautiful. Some say, oh, this body is very beautiful, something like that, you know. When you see disgusting of the body, you will can eradicate or abandon just the wrong view that this body is beautiful. This means the abandoning also is different. Now, who contemplate on the body, the object is the body, the seeing is the disgusting, just the abandoning is the wrong view that this body is the beautiful. For number two, vedana nupasana satipatthana, contemplation of the feelings, this feeling, there are five kinds of feelings regarding about the bodies, two, regarding about the minds, the three, right? I believe these are three. A pleasurable feeling, an unpleasurable feeling, and neutral feeling. And you see that, you know, when you observe your mind on the feeling, first you see your pleasurable feeling, and then from pleasurable feeling or displeasurable feeling, just change. Just this feelings that change all the time. When you see the vedana, the feelings changing all the time, you see just all these feelings being oppressed by arising and disappearing. Just arising and disappearing. And then what you see the dukkha, suffering. Mostly you see the dukkha, suffering, or like just now I feel comfortable, now it's not comfortable, something like that. You know, you see just the change of all this stuff feeling. Just because dukkha. It's not only because pain is dukkha. Dukkha, suffering here is mean whatever stuff, being oppressing by arising and disappearing is more clear in your view. You see all this suffering. When you see just the seeing, when you contemplate on this feeling, you will see the suffering. Right? You see suffering. When you see the suffering, and then you can eradicate the wrong view that this feeling or this mind or this body, this mind and matter is the pleasure. Right? You can eradicate or abandon the wrong view that this body and mind, this mind and matter or this feeling is pleasure. Because you see it's the suffering. Right? Dukkha and sukha. When you see dukkha, you will eradicate wrong view that is sukha. No sukha, no pleasure, just the dukkha. Right? This vedana upasana satipatthana is very important. It's very obvious to everyone. You know, when you practice meditation, this vedana can occur on your eye, ears, nose, tongue, body, and mind. What is the external object and I come to contact to your eye, and you see it, oh, it's a good object, desirable object, what kind of feeling? Pleasure feeling, pleasurable feeling, right? Is the object undesirable object? Yes, this pleasurable feeling. This object is the just neither good nor bad, upekkha, indifference feeling, right? So if you not contemplate on this the vedana, when you see something, some object, it's a good object, if it's pleasurable feeling, this become craving, lobha, right? Become lobha, lobha. Is the unpleasurable feeling become dosa? See, right? Dosa, anger will rise. Is neutral feeling moha? Maybe you don't know their nature. Maybe you ignore. This ignorance, that's moha. So, lobha, dosa, moha.
Do we Ultimately, do we want to experience all of our sensations as Vekka, equanimity with all of our sensations? Ultimately, with a lot of meditation, is that instead of feeling it as pleasure or pain, ultimately, are all sensations, we just see it as neutral?
Oh, yes, just say as, yes, as they really are. Something, or mostly it's the pleasure, rubber feeling and pleasure is very obvious, you know, very clear. For a neutral feeling, it's not not clear. But if you not observe on this your eye, ears, nose, tongue, body and mind, without mindfulness, you cannot grasp the feeling. And then it can become, you will ignore it because you think the fear is not normal for you, right? And then if you observe on your, or supposing you see something, if the object is not, you know, just, it's not good, you know, it's not so bad, something like that. And then what you feel? Just ubekha, right? Ubekha. This ubekha, you have to, it's not condemnation, it's just seeing. You see, just seeing. The seeing consciousness arises and disappears. A seeing consciousness is jaku vijnana. Ubekha sagata jaku vijnana. See that, right? This I consciousness accompanies with indifference, feeling, ubekha. You see, the seeing. This means you contemplate on upekha. See that, right? Upekha feeling. So, without mindfulness, this I just explained to all of you, this from three kind of feelings, I can produce this lobha, dosa, and moha to arise. As all of you know, if pleasurable feeling can become craving, right? If this pleasurable feeling can become anger, dosa, right? From this neutral feeling can become moha, ignorance, right? You ignore it to become. So that's why we have to be aware of all the time. Whatever is occurring in our six centers, otherwise lobha, dosa, and moha will arise. Just according to this the foundation of mindfulness, contemplate on feeling, what kind of feeling arises in your body or in your mind must be, you know, stop it right there. Right? You see, happy, yes, happy. You stop like this. You should not go beyond. If you go beyond, it's not stop right there. Maybe grasping. I mean, try to buy physically, mentally, or mentally to get that one. This is they call paricca-samuppada, the law of dependent origination keep going. So that's why we need to stop and stop, vedana. Right? When you see, just seeing, when you hear, just hearing, when you smell, smelling, when you taste, just tasting, when you touch, just touching, when you think, just thinking. We stop right there. So what we need the steep mindfulness.
You can
say that too, you know. So when you see suffering, you can abandon the wrong view of this pleasure. And who practice citta anupassana satipatthana? Yeah. Citta anupassana satipatthana here. Oh, as all of you know, our mind sometimes passionate mind, some passionate mind, some angry mind occurs, some the lazy mind occurs. I mean, whatever your mind occurs, so you make a mental note, realize it, identify it right away. Now, I'm angry, angry minds occur. Sometimes you feel lazy, or the lazy minds occur, you realize it, know it. So briefly, what kind of consciousness, what kind of mind, as we study 121 kind of consciousness, but for meditation, we cannot contemplate on all these 121. Just should be the mundane consciousness, supramundane consciousness. We cannot make as our meditation object. You want something, we call passionate mind, right? Just arises in your mind, you realize it. When this mind go away, you know that. If you don't want anything, right? You get angry, you know it. And you feel lazy, you know it. Something like that. Yeah, contemplate on our mind. It's because citta anupassana, satipatthana. This mind, the arising and disappearing of this mind, more obvious than matter. As the mind and matter, as we study as chapter 4, the mind is the arising this being more than matter 17 times. Remember that, right? 17 times. This matter arising and this being, right? As the moment of the arising this being one term of this matter for the mind that will arise in this 17 times. So the mind is faster than the matter 17 times. So when we contemplate on this mind, as you contemplate on the mind, and then you will see your mind just wonder. You want something, you want that, you want this, something like that. And then you will get angry, and then you feel happy. During just a few minutes, your mind can change, you know, change many, many times. As the you know very clear, more than you contemplate on the body, clearer than on the body. See, our minds go very fast. Just rising this being. Just now, I try to sit meditation for 5 minutes. Maybe your minds go all over, right? Yeah. So you see, impermanence. When you contemplate on the mind, you will see impermanence very clear. Just arising and disappearing. Mostly, right? Mostly, you will see the impermanence. When you see impermanence of this mind, you can abandon the wrong view that this mind is permanent. Right? This mind is permanent. Or maybe somebody say, oh, my mind is not changed like before. You know, maybe since we was born until now, maybe it's the same mind. Maybe we think that, you know, someone they think that it's the same mind. It's not the same mind, you know. As we study and as we practice meditation, we know that this mind is the arising and disappearing all the time. So clear, they are impermanent. And when you see impermanent, you will abandon the wrong view that's permanent. This mind permanent. Just opposite, right? They say, you know, this person is a bad person, you know it's not good. Right? If you see this impermanent, you know this, you can eradicate the wrong view that this mind is permanent. So you have to know the object, or the seeing, the abandonment. For number four, Dhammanupassana Satipatthana. The contemplation of the Dhamma, or the mental object. The Dhamma mental object here, there are five parts of Dhamma object. Please note that. Dhamma object here, number one is the Nivarana in Pali, Nivarana, hindrances. Nivarana, we already studied about it, hindrances, Nivarana. Number two is the Khanda. Khanda is the five aggregates. And Ayarana, basis. Ayarana is basis, I base, something like that, you know. Ayarana, basis. And Satya is the truth. The Four Noble Truths, right? Truth. And five is the Bhojanga. Bhojanga is the factor of enlightenment. The factor of enlightenment. This is because Dhamma object, there are five parts, right? Nivarana, hindrances, khanda, five aggregates, ayarana, basis, satya is truth, and the bhojanga is the factor of enlightenment. We just all study only nivarana, hindrances, right? For khanda, ayarana, satya, bhojanga. Maybe we study maybe today or tomorrow. So, even if you not study yet, all of you already know what is the khanda means, five aggregate, right? This sixth sense basis, or this four noble truth, you already know that. The bhojanga, the factor of enlightenment, the seven, we will study later. If we contemplate on this one of this object, we call Dhamma object, or mental object. We cannot see from our eye, ears, nose, tongue, body, should be by mind. It's called mental object. That's Nivarana. What is Nivarana? Hindrances, right? Our sense, desire, remember that, right? Ill will, and sloth and torpor, restlessness, or remorse, doubt. So, when you contemplate on this Dhamma object, maybe you want something about the sense, desire. I want this. And then you know, now, one kind of nivarana, hindrances, occurs in my mind. When you stand desires or disappear, you know that. This means if you, when they arise, you know, when they disappear, you know that. This means you contemplate on Dhammanupassana Satipatthana. If you talk one by one. But sometimes ill will, get angry with someone, you know, you're not satisfied with anything, just arises in your mind. You know that, I'm getting angry right now. Now this anger is the despair, you know that. Sometimes sloth and torpor, right? You don't want to do anything. You don't want to sit meditation, you don't want to do the moral action. You feel drowsiness at that moment, it's not on top. You know that one of hindrances occurs is your mind, you know that. When it's all now, I will not feel sleepy, drowsy, now just go away, you know that. But just you know the hindrances, when they occur, you know, when they disappear, you know that. Sometimes your mind starts wonder. You cannot control your mind, even you try so hard. You cannot control your mind. Your mind should distract, you know, just wonder. You know that. When you try to practice, try to observe your mind on your primary object, and your mind is steady. You know, my wandering mind, now, I disappear. Now I or in concentration, you know that. And sometimes the remorse, what you have done before, stick about your face. Very sorry about that. Remorse occur. And sometimes when it occurs, you know. When the disappear, you know that. And sometimes you doubt about something, you can make decision, any decision. Oh, what I have to do about it? What I have to make decision about it? Sometimes you doubt about something. The ujjikicca. When you rest your mind, you realize yourself, your mind. When it disappears, you know that. This may be contemplate on Dhamma nupasana, Dhamma object, mental object. So everyone we experience about it. Maybe we just we don't know the name. Now we study the name, their nature. You know, some say, oh, I don't know what has happened to me. I, you know, have emotion arises in my mind, something like that. It's the Dhamma object. Whatever is arising in your mind, just observe on it. This Dhamma nupasana. Right? It's the object of meditation. Sometimes even, you know, we try so hard to observe our mind on our primary object, you cannot make and you get angry with yourself. If you don't know the technique, it's just for to do that, you know, so to be like that. If angry man's occur, just, oh, I'm angry, you know. That's, then you know it's angry man's occur, and then the angry will go away. It's impermanent, right? So let's just try to observe whatever stuff, this kind of things occur in your mind. So this for the briefly, for the nivarana, for the khanda. See, khanda. We have five aggregates. What is five aggregates? Take the view. Yes, the body, the feeling, the sensation, and perception, mental formation, consciousness, right? Whatever this one of these five, how can you just know, oh, this is my body, or this feeling, or this perception, this mental formation, this consciousness, arise, this disappear. If you know that, contemplate on it, it's the Dhamma object too. That's ayarana. Ayarana, we have six and internal six and bases, right? Or eye bases, ear bases, or tongue, body, mind, body and mind. Six external bases, six. We ayarana 12, we already studied about that, right? Ayarana. So when you see something, you see, or see. You concentrate your mind on your eye. You make a mental note to see. When you see, what do you see? You see the object. Object. This object is the ayarana. Right? Ayarana. And to be able to see this object, because you have your eye, this is the eye sensitivity. Right? Eye-based, right? Eye-based. You contemplate on your eye-based. And then eye consciousness arises. You will notice that even the object, your eye, sandals, right, and your consciousness, you know that every moment just arising and disappearing, rising and disappearing. That's why we have to contemplate on, observe on our eye, ears, nose, tongue, body, and mind. At that moment, we'll be called, because we contemplate on this Dhamma object or mental object. When we make a mental seeing, hearing, smelling, tasting, touching, thinking, and so on. This for the kind of irony. For the satya, the noble truth, right? The satya, you know this is suffering. Why I suffer? Because of this. You know the cause, right? You know the cause, you know that. Just the suffering, the cause of suffering, something like that. This means you contemplate on Dhamma object. A bojanga, they have seven. We study later, seven. There's the mindfulness, right? Investigation, or effort, or rapture, or joy, and concentration, equanimity. We have seven. So So if contemplate on the seven also, we call Dhamma object. So we cannot, you know, it's a very wide, right? Just the Nivarana, Khanda, Arana, Satya, Bhojanga, the object. But briefly, I would all of you to remember briefly, whatever you contemplate on, maybe on your body, maybe on your Vedana, maybe on your consciousness, maybe on this Nivarana, Khanda, Arana, Satya, or Bhojanga, if you see the nature of the impermanence and suffering is called Dhammanupassana Satipatthana. You see the arising of this spirit. Or supposing you contemplate on Kayanupassana Satipatthana, right? Contemplation of the body. But you see, if you see the arising and dispelling of this your body, what we call Dhammanupassana Satipatthana. Yes, the nature of, you know, thing. The nature of mind and body.
How do you know the difference between the
Chittavipassana
and Dhammanupassana?
Oh, Chitta just, oh, this Chitta is the mind. Or oh, mind, just a, oh, something. Your mind is one something we call passionate mind. Passionate when you want something arising in your mind. And when this something you don't want anything. In Pali they call raga chitta, viraga chitta. Raga chitta, just a passionate mind. You want something. If your mind wants something, you know that. Contemplate, oh, my mind wants something. Now, or passionate mind just arises. Now, there's this fears, no, or passionate mind, something like that. Or some angry mind, angry, just mind, your mind, angry mind is okay, you know that. Or just my angry mind. And later on, your angry mind is to go away, you know there's no angry mind. And the Dhamma object here is, as I told you right just now, you know, or the condom or Nivarana, Khanda, Arana, Satya, Bhojanga, but briefly, just if you see the nature of mind and body arising and disappearing, you don't see this the body, you don't see that it's the Vedana, this the Chitta, you just see arising and disappearing, the Dhammanupassana
Satipatthana. The Chitta is more of a mental state,
but coming up. Oh, yeah, just, it's not, this mind. Yeah, it's just mind, right? It's mind, it's thought, your mind, your consciousness. Chitta is the thought, mind, your consciousness. I mean, easy, Dhammanupassana Satipatthana, just you see the nature of the arising and disappearing of mind and matter. When you see this Dhammanupassana Satipatthana here, when you contemplate on this object, mental object, you see, just arising and disappearing, your nature, there's no person. You don't see as the our entity here, right? Or individually. You just see arising this pain, we call anatta. No self. Right? You see no self, anatta. All this kaya, this body, this feeling, vedana, this jitta, mind, when they arise, this, we cannot control it. Depend on their nature, as their nature, just arise this pain all the time. So, when you know this arising and disappearing, know their nature, it's called anatta. So, no body. No, it's a, you know, man, no woman, something like that. You see anatta. When you see anatta, you can start abandon the wrong view that this, this the, what do you call it, self, soul. Body is man or woman, something like that. You eradicate this strong view. According to the Dhamma, it's nature. Right? It's nature. So, there are objects, it's four objects, you already know that, right? Object. They are seeing Kaya Nupasana Satipatthana, what they see mostly. discarding, right? Disgusting of the body, right? Impurity of the body, right? And for a, and then they will eradicate what's wrong with you. Beautiful, yeah. Beautiful and so on, right? When it's contemplating on Vedananupasana, Satipatthãna, you see the suffering. When you see suffering, you can abandon just feeling this mind and this body is the pleasure. So Chittanupasana, Satipatthãna, you see impermanence. When you see impermanence, you can eradicate strong view that permanent, right? Permanent. So Dhamma, when you contemplate on Dhamma, Dhamma object here, you will see anatta, no self, uncontrollable, right? And then you will eradicate around you then, self or soul, immortal ego, something like that, immortal soul. So we now we know the object of this four foundation of mindfulness, and they are seeing or they are abandoning the different, right? That's what the Buddha taught us the Satipatthãna as four. Especially who practice vipassana meditation, we need to, you know, this practice Satipatthãna, the foundation of mindfulness meditation. Without this Satipatthãna, the full foundation of mindfulness meditation, you can experience about the bhojanga. Bhojanga is a state or strong mindfulness investigation, effort, rapture, tranquility of mind, concentration, and equanimity, or neutrality of mind. So, when, at least when you practice meditation, you will see the arising and disappearing of mind and matter, and that's the seven kind of effect of enlightenment will occur. And then, you can realize that the noble truth can get enlightenment. So whatever technique you make as your primary object, it's not consists into just the four foundation of meditation, it's not inside vipassana meditation. Right? Maybe some just can only answer any object outside, external. Here will be especially in our body, right? Internal to our body, our feeling, our consciousness, the nature of this body and feeling and consciousness. Dhamma nupasana Satipatthãna. Now we go to Sammapadana 4. Sammapadana 4, the supreme effort. Supreme effort. This one I already explained to you about since Sammavayama, right effort, right? Just right effort and supreme effort is the same, right? Same. Here, Sammapadana 4, supreme effort, right? Something called right exertion. Here, number one, the name's long, right? Upananam Pabaganam Pahanaya Vayamo. Just remember Vayamo. Vayamo is a Vayama, right? What is Vayama? Effort. Right, effort. Here, upananam is meant here the effort to discard evil that have arisen. The effort to discard evil that have arisen. Upanana here is mean arisen. Right? The meaning of upanana is the arisen. Pabakana is evil. Pabakana is mean evil. Pahanaya here is mean discard. To remove, right? Discard. Vayamo is mean effort. That's why upanana, pabakana, pahanaya, vayamo is mean the effort to discard evil that have risen. When we practice meditation, should secrete or hatred or envy and so on can arise in your mind, your view. And then as soon as they arise in your mind, you have to realize, labor it, you know, identify, make a maintenance, that depends on your technique, you know. And then let this great hatred, envy, jealousy go away, right away. Just mean the effort to discard evil that have arisen. For this one, I was saying all of you, since we study the 12 maganga, right? Piyasama, Vayama. How to discuss the evil that have arisen. You have done demeritorious deed. You know, it's not allowed to occur again. Right? Not allowed to occur again. It's the same, just evil. It's not allowed to occur again. Don't think, try to forget it. The same thing what you have done before, right? You can call it as to discuss the old evil, what you have done. Effort number two, anupannanam papakanam anupadaya vayam. Here, anupannanam here, anupannanam, anupannanam, right? Anupannanam means unrisen. Pabakanam is the evil. Anupadaya is mean for not risen. That's why the full meaning here, anupabakanam, anupananam, papakanam, anupadaya vayamo. This means the effort to prevent the arising of unarisen evils. The effort to prevent the arising of unarisen evils. That means it's not allows the new evils occur in your mind. What you never done before, right? Don't let it happen in your mind. This means less that the new evil will happen. You never drink alcohol before. So try to, you know, to use the efforts to prevent the rising of this new evil. anupanānam kusalānam upādāya vāyamo is mean the effort to develop and reason good. The effort to develop and reason good. What you never do before, try to do it. About this moral conduct, right? About moral action, about good deed, about the meritorious deed. Oh, yeah, when kusala, no, kusala is a kusala, it's just a good, just moral. Yes, that. Kusala, akusala, moral, immoral, right? It's kusala, it's moral. It's good. It's the effort to develop and reason good. If you never practice meditation, start to do it. Something like that, right? Effort number four. Upanānam kusalānam piñño bhāvāya vāyam. The upanānam here is mean risk. Kusalānam is good. Piñño bhāvāya is mean to promote. Right? The effort to promote the reason good. This means we still doing this some meritorious deed. It's not perfect yet, right? Try to promote, increase. Formerly, maybe sit meditation twice a day, now try. Three times a day, right? If you used to practice meditation 1 hour, one time 1 hour, now 2 hours, something like that. Increase everything, you know, it's a good thing. This means the effort to promote the right, this reason good. For this samabhadana, for supreme effort, you know, in detail, you know, we already discussed about that since Sama Vayama. So here we don't need to explain in detail again. What is the essential element here? Vayama is mean virya. Right? Virya. Virya is one kind of mental state. Vayama, right? Vayama usually is the virya can associate with 73 types of consciousness, but here only 21. So virya in wholesome consciousness 21. It's called Samapadana. Samapadana. Because this section is regarding about body back here, right? The effort, just the factor of enlightenment. That's why just take only 21. Virya in 21 wholesome consciousness. It's their realities. See that, right? Even as four Satipatthãna, their reality is only one, Satipatthika, right? Here, Samabhadana, their reality is only one, Virya, only one. Now we go to Iddhipãda. Iddhipãda. Iddhi here is mean accomplishment. Pada is the foundation. So, Iddhipãda 4 is mean foundation of accomplishment. Foundation of full foundation of accomplishment. Therefore, To be successful, our goal or our aim, we need this Iddhipãda. Four. This Iddhipãda four is to like a deity, predominant. See that here. Number one, Chandidipada. See that right? Chandidipada. This means Chanda Iddhipãda. And number two, Viriyatipada. This means Virya Iddhipãda. Number three is Cittatipada. This means Citta Iddhipãda. Number four is Vimansa Iddhipada. This is Vimansa Iddhipada. Last 2 weeks ago, we studied about Dibri, right? Chana Dibri, Virya Dibri, Citta Dibri, Vimansa Dibri. Just a Dibri Iddhipãda, the same. Their names are different, right? Their names are different. So, Chanditipada here is will, wish to do, or desire. Desire. Uriyadibri is just effort. Chiditipada is the thought. Vimansa Iddhipãda, yes, wisdom or reason. Whatever you do, you have to have strong desire, strong will. Otherwise, you cannot succeed your goal. It's the chana. Number one is their reality is the chana. Chana is one kind of mental factors, like chana. This chana in 21 wholesome consciousness is called Chandidipada. You have desires to do generosity, the morality, just observe your precept by this meditation, and so on. You would like to gain enlightenment, if you have strong desire. If your desire is not so strong, you face any obstacle, and then you will quit. Right? So you have strong desire, anyhow. I try until I, gain, reach to my goal. It's not normal chanda, normal desire here. For virya here, effort. It's strong effort. But virya, this virya also one kind of mental factors. This virya in 21 type of wholesome consciousness. Even if you have strong desire, if you don't have strong effort, lazy, you cannot, succeed your goal. You have strong effort. One day, 24 hours a day, right? You sleep over 10 hours a day. You cannot succeed anything. Even this worldly affair should be, sleep about 5 hours, 6 hours, just now. It's not mean not sleep, just sleep 5, 6 hours, just so. Watch the TV, watch the movie, it's not, I don't mean like that, Try to practice meditation. Right? It's not, maybe you say, Janjia said you should be sleep only 5 hours, so I will sleep 5 hours a day, just play the tape, listen the music, song. it's not right. Try the best you can, you know, be mindful all the time. Despite this meditation, use your strong effort to fulfill our spiritual goal. Iddhipãda, number three, thought. Thought is the consciousness, the mind, right? The mind. This mind is the citta, right? Citta, how many citta we have? 89 type of citta, right? Consciousness. But here, just take supramundane consciousness, 8. Citta here, the supramundane consciousness, 8. Oh, yes, a couple of. See, your mind, whatever you do, your mind should be, should not quit, you know, even you or have something, someone's against you, comes to block your way, your mind is not disappointed. You tried it, you know, until you succeed your goal. Yeah, especially when you practice meditation, you should make decision. Right? Says, oh, when I practice meditation, let my body, you know, be used to skin and bone. Just finally, just remains is my bone and skin, you know, and let my flesh dry out, you know, your blood, your flesh dry out, just only, there's no blood in your body, you know. I try the best I can, you know, even the my life come to an end. I don't quit. I don't stop. I will not quit. I will not stop until I succeed my goal. Make this strong decision. This is called Iddhipãda. It's not normal level, right? This is the foundation of accomplishment. Unless my, this is the skin and bones be reduced, right? Let my blood and flesh dry up. No, let my life come to an end, but I will not stop, I will not quit until I succeed my goal. So you should keep this decision in your mind. And number four here, we must see the product. Reason or wisdom is reality is moha. Here, usually when we study chapter 2, wisdom amoha associated with 47 type of consciousness, right? But here, just 17 wholesome consciousness are taken here. 7 in wholesome consciousness. Amoha, right? 17. Where is 17? Wisdom associated with Mahakusala Jana Sambayuta 4. Remember, right? 4. And sublime rupa arupa, right? Wholesome consciousness, nine, right? Four and nine, thirteen. Magga, four. So 13 and plus 4, 17. So we call wholesome.